So good evening once again. We are starting the session. See, today the session is going to be on Become an Amazon Prime Seller. So today Mr. Aniruddha Rathi, manager of Amazon Prime, is here to take us through this session. A little introduction about him. Aniruddha Rathi, Prime Enablement Manager, South India, with direct sales Amazon India Marketplace, has graduated from BITS Pilani Mechanical Engineering in 2012 and completed his MBA from FMS Delhi in 2017. He has an experience of 3 years with Amazon India Marketplace in sales and category management roles. He has worked with strategic sellers, key offline retailers and brands during his tenure at Amazon. See, for today's session, we also have Mr. Omkar Kamath and Mr. Puthuraj Shanbog and Mr. Vikas Shahu from his business development team. I request Anirudh to take over the session, please. See, one small request for all the participants. Please kindly mute your microphone and no video, please, because we might be experiencing bandwidth problem. Kindly cooperate. Anirudh, you can take over, please.
Yeah. Hi. Thank you, Sandhya. And a very good afternoon to all the attendees. Sandhya, can you please share, give me the presenter
yeah,
right? Hi Sandhya, can you have a look at the screen? Are you able to see the screen?
Yeah, an invitation to sell on Amazon. Yeah, we can see.
Okay, fair enough. Can we start?
Yes, sure.
Okay, hi, good afternoon to all the members. So myself, Aniruddha Rathi, and thank you, Sandhya, for the kind introduction. We got in touch with Mr. Santosh. He got in touch with Mr. Prasanna from, who's the director of direct sales team at Amazon India Marketplace. And I think this discussion happened on Tuesday, and we are now having a joint conference call between more than 100 members on a Saturday. So I think this is something what we call in Amazon as great bias for action and ownership. So I would like to thank Mr. Santosh as well. So I have three of my team members who are here with me, who are to assist regarding this session. Mr. Omkar Kamath, Mr. Puthuraj Shanbog, and Mr. Vikas Sahu. So the flow of the whole session will be that I'll just take you guys through a quick presentation, something very basics about what is exactly Amazon, what is Amazon India Marketplace, and what does it mean to sell on Amazon. And after that, maybe we can have the question answer round for another 30-35 odd minutes. Okay. Okay. So I'll just start. When we say about, so about e-commerce in India, so unfortunately, not just India, but the whole world right now is in midst of a pandemic of COVID-19, and it has brought humongous challenges to whether it is online business, whether it is offline business, or and across all walks of life. Yeah, across all walks of life. So the whole idea is also that in this age of social distancing, as well as numerous other challenges, how do businesses keep on running? So e-commerce, because of the way it is structured, right, the number, lesser number of contacts, plus customers might not have to essentially go into the crowded markets, What we believe is that e-commerce is definitely here to stay, and it will definitely be something which will adoption of e-commerce is something which will definitely accelerate, will accelerated not just by the change in the customer pattern, customer buying patterns, but also that more and more sellers, more and more brands would also like to be associated with the e-commerce platforms. So just to give you some kind of a brief about e-commerce in India, I mean, there have been numerous news articles, there has been numerous analysis across the media which speaks about the projected growth of e-commerce. So this is something which I'm just highlighting it over here. 20x growth in about 10 years time. E-commerce was a very, very nascent industry about 10 years ago. Right now, it is definitely one of the key industries which has generated huge amount of employment and has supported a lot of MSMEs as well over the course of the last 7 to 8 years. So it's not just MSMEs, but there are across the board large brands, offline players. Everyone now wants to be associated with e-commerce in their own particular way. There are brands, there are key brands who are associated with Amazon India Marketplace, for whom even in their annual business plan, Amazon as well as other e-commerce portals then definitely becomes a critical piece of their overall revenue as well as profit numbers in their balance sheets. So this is more or less about the e-commerce in India. What exactly, how does Amazon exactly fit into this? Well, we like to say that we are India's number one online shopping destination, more than 20 crore products, 6 lakh plus unique sellers, most visited e-commerce site. In fact, more than Google, Amazon is actually the preferred destination for product search. I mean, if you look at the Alexa rank of Amazon.India, it is amongst the top 100 websites which is visited across across the world. One in four customers research products on Amazon before making an offline purchase as well. So Amazon has more or less built an ecosystem which has kind of, so one of the key themes that Amazon, when it started its operations in India, was that we really wanted to change the way that India buys and sells. So it's kind of, I think, although we are still not yet there, but I think we've fairly changed or changed customer experience. We've greatly enhanced the customer experience with the offerings, as well as we've given a lot of opportunity. Amazon Marketplace gives a lot of opportunity to offline brands as well to increase their reach. Just to give you a few examples, there could be local Ayurveda brands, there could be local furniture brands who might have been doing business in a particular geography since the last 10 years, 20 years, 30 years, legacy brands, which are well known in their captive markets. But Amazon, the infrastructure which Amazon has through this marketplace model, this has really helped a lot of brands to scale over the last 5 years to increase their reach across India. We also have certain programs wherein sellers in India can actually sell on other, on international marketplaces as well, such as EU as well as US and UAE. So starting to sell on Amazon.India is just the start. I mean, there are multiple things which sellers or brands in the offline market can explore and increase their business. So what exactly is a marketplace? So basically what Amazon in, what we say as a marketplace is that Amazon is a technology platform which brings sellers and buyers together. Sellers can decide which are the products they want to list, what are the fulfillment model. Think of it as an offline shopping mall wherein you have multiple sellers, or an offline bazaar wherein there are multiple sellers, vendors, brands, offline retailers who want to sell their wares. What marketplace actually does is that we help out with the logistics, we help out with the promotional activities, and we help out Anirudh, with the commercial transactions as well.
Anirudh,
yeah.
Excuse me, few people are saying it is not audible.
Sorry, am I not audible?
Few of them have sent message that you are not audible, that is why.
Okay, just one second. Am I audible?
Yes, audible. Yes, it is audible very well.
It's very much audible. So very those much. Who are complaining, let them go, exit and then come in.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
Very audible. Very audible.
Okay. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Okay. So this is the business model of marketplace. So we help out with the logistics, payments, and the promotional activities. We'll go into depth of in terms of how each one of these vertical essentially works. But this is more of what we are in India, as well as in other parts of the world. So now essentially how do you essentially grow your business, right? So we have any seller who has a standard GST and a bank account details and PAN details, any seller is free to come register themselves on our platform and become a seller. Basis the certain qualification criteria, we there might be certain categories which might, for example, a grocery category, which we will cover later, wherein you might need additional certifications like an FSSAI license, or there could be some other baby products wherein you might need some additional certification. But basis the qualification criteria, any seller or any brand who has a GST number, bank account, valid bank account details, and a valid PAN number can come and sell online. So what essentially happens is that each and every seller or a brand will get their own sellers. What we have is a portal called as Seller Central. You will get your own login details, and then you can browse through it, make your inventory, make your products live, increase the inventory, change the fulfillment channels, change the pricing, go opt in for promotions. So there are no charges once for coming on Amazon. It's only when you sell is when the charges will be deducted. So coming on Amazon is absolutely free of cost. That is why most brands tend to break even within 6 to 9 months of coming on Amazon, compared to almost 2 to 3 years what it takes for them to set up their online business. Plus the infrastructure costs are something which are definitely very, very commendable. Most of the online business which starts is from their existing offline infrastructure. So typically the fixed costs which are involved are also extremely reduced. Typically what you need is a laptop, internet connection, to just set to set up your business. That's the basic bare minimum equipment that you would essentially be required. We will also be speaking about the payment cycle, what would be the referral rates, and again, when it comes to the customer base, more than 100 we have more than 100 million customers across India. We service about 99.6% of India's pin codes. The remaining 0.4 would typically fall into defense pin codes. So apart from that, we deliver goods to 99.4% of India's pin codes. Yeah. So what essentially are the fulfillment options? So when we mean by fulfillment options, a lot has been discussed about the operations and the logistics capability of e-commerce firms in India. So we have essentially broadly two types of fulfillment centers. One is something what we call as Fulfilled by Amazon. We have fulfillment centers across 13 states, and in another 10 states we have third party warehouses which kind of run as a proxy for fulfillment centers for Amazon. So what essentially happens in fulfillment center, so if you look at the storage, packaging, and the last mile delivery, these are essentially services that are provided by Amazon through their fulfillment models. So if in a fulfillment model, you can in a fulfillment center, you can park your inventory, the ownership of the inventory continues to be that of the seller. You can park your inventory in the fulfillment center, the packaging as well as the dispatch to the customer, as well as the last mile delivery to the customer is also something which is the owners of Amazon. So again, there are multiple and for each and every service, there are different types of charges which will be applicable. There is something called as a flex model, wherein we convert the warehouse of the seller into a fulfillment center for our own, and Amazon takes care of the pickup as well as the last mile delivery of the orders which are placed on the seller. Now, Seller Flex is a premium offering from Amazon, which only sellers who cross a certain threshold of business or satisfy the criteria. I think everyone needs to go on mute.
Sanjay ji, mute everybody.
Okay, so Seller Flex is a premium model, like I mentioned, wherein Seller Flex is given as an option to select sellers who fulfill certain objective criteria of business or any other business requirements, such as selection or inventory requirements for the marketplace. Easy Ship is something wherein, again, we do do the pickup from the seller's premises itself, but the timeline. So, for example, in Seller Flex, the delivery promise to the customer could be anywhere between 2 to 4 days, depending on the location of the Seller Flex as well as the order, as well as the customer from which pin code the order is being placed. Whereas in EasyShip, the timelines could be slightly more. In the merchant fulfilled, the second option is self ship, wherein you can deliver the orders to the customers through your own logistics partners. So these are predominantly the four different fulfillment models or the logistics model which essentially connect a seller to the customer, to its customer. Now, which would be the gold standard? Essentially, fulfillment centers as well as Flex would be the gold standard, wherein we are able to provide fast delivery to the customers. Next would be EasyShip, and the third one would be the SelfShip. So now, what would be the benefits of FBA? So I mentioned that fulfillment centers are present in Delhi, Haryana, Punjab, Rajasthan, and the mentioned over there. What essentially happens if you park your inventory into with Amazon fulfillment center? Yeah, what essentially happens is that increased visibility. The first and foremost, you get a Fulfilled by Amazon or a Prime tag. I'm sure a lot of you guys would be Amazon Prime customers. With Prime comes a whole suite of other benefits, such as video, music. In fact, recently, Amazon Gaming has also been launched about 2 or 3 days ago.
Hello, who is this? Who is this causing sound? Yeah, remove that lady. Please remove that lady. He is causing a lot of.
See, it is waiting for name. It is not listed out that particular person. But I don't know how it is.
Mute everybody. It's really, the presenter, it's difficult for
me. Anirudh, you please unmute yourself. I'm muting everybody now.
Yeah, sure. Can you see the presentation, Sandhyaji?
Anirudh, you can continue, please.
Yeah. Okay. So, benefits of fulfillment by Amazon, increased visibility of your products. We will cover during the next half, next part of the presentation in terms of what does visibility mean. Inventory management and order processing by Amazon, 100% pin code coverage, like I mentioned, apart from the few defense pin codes. Eligibility for deals and promotions, faster 1 day, 2 day delivery options, and eligibility to win the buy box. And more than this, the premium benefits would be getting an Amazon fulfilled or a Prime tag. More than 80% of the business which happens on Amazon is through Prime. And this is, in fact, there was a survey which was done on the US marketplace and this was almost like 3 to 4 years ago. Considering US marketplace is a much, much mature marketplace, Prime customers spend almost 2.5 to 3 times more on Amazon compared to non-Prime customers. So if you are on Amazon, it is absolutely, as a seller, it is absolutely imperative that you have a Prime tag. So as to increase the scope of your business and to increase the reach of your product offerings as well. Like I mentioned, these are the full states wherein Amazon has their own fulfillment centers. Apart from that, there are about 10 or 11 or more states wherein we have third-party logistics providers who are working as a warehousing service provider for us. Okay. Now the question comes is that you have listed your products on Amazon. We have more than 20 crore products. I will list maybe say a honey or maybe a curtain. How exactly will my curtain come on the first page, right? And this is exactly similar to what happens in the offline space as well. When you go to a supermarket, say for example DMart, you will see that the most fast-selling products or the most the brands which customers love the most are something which are in front of the shelf, whereas the other brands are kept behind. So this is again the similar kind of customer psyche works on Amazon as well. So for example, how do you if you list, for example, a new curtain SKU, right? So how does it like get more traffic? And like in the offline world, jo dikhta hai wohi bikta hai. So the more traffic that is generated, which in Amazonian terms we call it as glance views, the more glance views that your product gets, the higher is the propensity for it to sell on Amazon. Now, how do you promote any specific product? We have a property called as sponsored products, wherein you can start, you can essentially start advertising, you can start bidding. This is a cost per click property so as to promote your products. Typically, any new seller who comes on Amazon gets 2000 rupees worth of free credit so as to try this property, and basis that as and when depending upon the promotional budget that you have allocated for your products, the say and the advertising clicks that you have garnered over advertising clicks you would have garnered over the course of the the same will be deducted in the subsequent payment cycle. Now, what this really helps is to boost your sales as well as to increase the product discoverability. Okay, so this is this tag that is called sponsored, right? So any typically the search which happens on Amazon is through generic keywords. So people will be, for example, searching curtains under 1000, curtains for windows, curtains for doors, or something of that sort. And you would essentially want that the first four products which come on top are essentially sponsored products. You might not be able to see a lot of it right now because of this whole entire COVID situation, and we've not really dialed up our entire sponsored products offering. But once we come back to normal business, this is something which you'll be able to see it in a much more easier manner. Then we have something called as sponsored brands. Sponsored brands is more of a high visibility placement over search results. It was earlier called as headline search ads. So if you can see over here, these are more like banner ads. So banner ads, and typically these banner ads are something wherein you can even redirect this to your brand store. Brand store as a property is something which we can explain to you later during the presentation. The budget for this is slightly more higher. But it starts again as low as rupees 5 per click. But for new sellers or entry level sellers, it is advisable to start with the CPC or the sponsored products campaigns. This one compared to a sponsored brands campaign. Sponsored brand campaigns are something much more for mature sellers once you have kind of spent about 6 months on the platform. Okay, so I'll just go through this one. So what we call it as an hero ASIN, right? So categories on Amazon are nothing but a combination or a cluster of ASINs, what we call. So the full form of ASIN is essentially Amazon Standard Identification Number. So this is what we call it as an SKU in the offline world as well. We would essentially want the rank of the ASIN to be high. Any seller would essentially want the rank of his or her SKU to be as high as possible. The whole idea is that the higher your rank, the higher is the search visibility that you get for your particular products. Now, this is just as an example of a home decor curtain that I have taken across. So if you can see, the quality of the listings is something which matters a lot. The number of listings is something which matters a lot. If you look at the ratings, it has 128 ratings with almost 4-star reviews. And then there would be certain other imaging and cataloging which would be done as well. Also, there are brand content which can be developed. So once you scroll down, you will be able to see that there is a lot more information related to this particular brand as well and this particular product. So the best example of any A+ cataloging is anytime you can go and check on Amazon whenever a new OnePlus phone gets launched. So you will be able to see. So for example, in the last version of OnePlus which was launched, there was Robert Downey Jr. as well, and there was a video of him, and there are multiple high quality, high definition images. We don't really need to do that much for any basic marketplace brand, but yeah, somewhere in middle, if we have this kind of listings, that really increases the chance of conversion and consequently more sales. Again, even for apparel, right? Apparel is essentially, we would want to have model shots of white background. There are technical specifications which are available in the Seller Central account once you register on Amazon. Again, the price, MRP, I mean, it's also important that what exactly is the title. So this has almost a 3.8 star rating with 21 ratings. If you look at the sharpness of the image, it is extremely sharp. It's not pixelated. So the better is the quality of the imaging. And these things are extremely important for any entry level seller, because you are, if you list a product, so we have more than almost 50,000 apparel sellers on our platform. You coming in will be just 50,001. Now, how do you essentially differentiate yourself? That being said, even though we have more than 6 lakh sellers, a huge percentage of them start getting orders. And you must have seen the promotions during Diwali as well, wherein it is definitely the biggest shopping. It is the biggest shopping event for us during the entire year, wherein a lot of sellers essentially, and we are proud to say that a lot of sellers actually end up becoming Lakhpati and Karodpati sellers. So internally, we do speak about, you know, how the Karodpati club is being expanded year after year because of the sellers and brands who continue to be associated with Amazon over a long period of time. And Amazon is also invested in the growth of these brands, as well as the brands themselves are invested into the growth of their own business through Amazon. Okay, grocery store, and this is because Santosh ji mentioned that a lot of the attendees would essentially be from the grocery gourmet category. So we are essentially part of Amazon marketplace. Please do not confuse this with an Amazon Pantry or an Amazon Fresh or a Prime Now. That is more got to do with FMCG products, which are your typical daily staples. That's a completely different section. What sells on Amazon in the grocery category is mostly in the gourmet section. So if I have to actually check out, you know, which would be the top grocery and the gourmet subcategories on marketplace or as marketplace sellers, it would be cashews and dry fruits, different types of tea, herbal tea, flavored tea, honey, again, different variety of honey. In fact, we do see good traction of premium honey as well as muesli related items. We also see good traction of coffee related products. So these are some of the top grocery and gourmet subcategories which we see a good amount of traction on the Amazon India marketplace. I'm once again reiterating, it's very, very different from the Prime Now or the Amazon Fresh business offering. So that's a completely different vertical, and our team is not associated with that. Apart from that, considering the COVID situation that we find ourselves in, we are seeing huge traction for Ayurveda brands and other health and personal care brands as well. Amazon partially restored some of its operations since this Monday. And in fact, one of the fastest categories to pick up was the health and personal care category as well. So there is definitely a lot of customer sentiment which is now towards that. It could be as simple as maybe turmeric, or it could be as simple as your generic over-the-counter Ayurveda products. But yeah, we are definitely seeing a huge traction in those categories. And I think that kind of customer sentiment is here to stay. Okay, now we just want to run you guys through few of the programs. These are specialized programs which we have. Amazon Launchpad is one of this. It's a unique global platform which curates, showcases and delivers new and exciting products. These are typically B2C products, and considering that a lot of the folks over here would be from a startup background, interesting products which you guys have, which have a B2C appeal. This is something which Amazon will, you can definitely sign up for the Amazon Launchpad program, which will definitely help in terms of scaling up your reach to the customers. Just a simple flow in terms of what exactly happens if you sign up for the Launchpad program. Again, launch faster, get discovered, go global, build your brand. Definitely there would be some kind of a verification process which would be in place, because this was a highly specialized program which Amazon runs for products which have for startup products which have a B2C appeal. But yeah, this definitely is one of the key successful programs which we had over the past few years. Okay, for all the women entrepreneurs out there, we have something called as an Amazon Saheli program. Again, this is to promote typically women entrepreneur and how their products are also able to find some kind of recognizance on the Amazon India marketplace. If you can go on the services.amazon.india landing Amazon Saheli page, and it just gives you a whole list of products that you can do. In fact, for women entrepreneurs who qualify for the Saheli through one of our partners, reach out partners, there is a reduced referral fees as well for the women entrepreneurs in certain categories. So the women entrepreneurs out there can definitely take advantage of this. And maybe we can connect later through Santosh in terms of how do we take this forward. Apart from that, for the handloom as well as for the handicraft products, Amazon has an outreach program called as Amazon Karigar. It works with government bodies, aggregators, NGOs, special help groups, and artisans and weavers. Again, the whole idea here is to onboard as well as to give them some so as to give them this outlet into inlet into this world of e-commerce, because a lot of people actually feel that, you know, e-commerce is something which is extremely complicated, and might I think more than the complicated part, I think there is a lack of awareness about the way e-commerce operations are run. So even though we do have more than 6 lakh sellers who have registered with us and who have you know, started at some point of time their business on Amazon over the last 7 years, I think there's definitely a lot more out there in India, wherein we can definitely work with a lot of other organizations, including yours like CIM, SME, and, you know, work at scale in terms of how would you guys want to be associated with Amazon. Okay, so now, unfortunately, I had to keep this slide because we would definitely have had this discussion sometime or the other during the course of this 1.5 hours. What exactly is the fees? The fees on Amazon is typically divided into three parts. Like I mentioned, the fixed cost is something which is very, very negligible. It's a pay as you sell. There is no fees for registering yourself on Amazon. There is a referral fee, which depends on the category. There's a closing fees, which depends again on the fulfillment type as well as the cost of the product that you're selling. And then there is a shipping fee, whether it is a local, national, or regional, or one of the three fulfillment models which I had told earlier about, which is either fulfillment through our fulfillment center, fulfillment by Amazon through our fulfillment center, Sellerflex, or EasyShip. For Sellship, we will not be charging the shipping fee because the delivery to the customer will be done by the seller entity itself. Okay, what would be the payment terms? I think so. I've just pasted over here. Blue Ringer is an Amazon seller. This is just a testimonial. Unlike offline sales, wherein we have to wait for 40 to 45 days for payments, on Amazon we are paid after 7 days of the sale. Something what we call it as transaction plus 7. For any new seller, it's you can think of it something like a cred or a credit card, right? That once you sign up for any kind of a credit card, for a few days your credit limit remains for you know, for a period of time, and slowly and steadily your credit limit kind of increases basis your credit history. Similarly, for that, for any new seller, initially transaction plus 7 days is something which takes slightly much more time, because Amazon, for Amazon system, you would be a new seller, and it would also want to prevent abuse of sellers, right? I mean, early days of e-commerce are filled with stories about the abuse from sellers, the abuse from customers. And I think Amazon has learned a lot of lessons over the last 6 to 7 years. And we would definitely want to prevent abuse both from the seller's end as well as from the customer's end. But once you become a but once you do have 2 or 3 weeks of you know, sales cycle, after that the transaction plus 7 days of sale is something which kicks in, so you can be rest assured of that. Okay. Thank you. This is from my end. I think we can take questions, or Sandhya ma'am, how do you want to proceed?
We are over with your session. Yeah, definitely you can start taking questions from them.
Sorry, I can't
hear you. If you are done with the PPT, then probably
yes,
you can proceed with question answers.
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Yeah, we can
ask your questions, please.
Hi, this is Krishna here from Chennai. I have a question for Anirudh. You did briefly tell about what are the popular products that is running on the searches and stuff. From our perspective, for us to focus, we are focusing on certain product portfolios as a startup. So I want to know which product is in demand in terms of the search or in terms of the clicks. Which products are in demand? How do we find out? How can we access that, get those data?
Okay, so we will not be essentially able to share with you any product or category level specific data. Right now, Amazon operates across more than 50 categories and more than 600 subcategories, right? So, so which kind of product are you talking about?
I'm talking about food product like organic rice,
okay,
organic pulses.
Okay, organic rice and organic pulses, right? Just 1 second. Yeah, organic rice and organic pulses, right?
Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah.
Yeah, so we have something called as a new, if you must have seen, I will share the details of a press release which just went live a few days ago called as local shops. We have that kind of a fulfillment model wherein we are now starting to work with certain grocery as well as, for example, when you mentioned the organic rice and the pulses categories as well. You can decide the catchment area that you want to service the customer demand for these kind of products, and you can do the delivery yourself.
Okay.
Yeah.
And for the Amazon Launchpad will help us to get all the other details if we log in.
No, so Launchpad again, so you might apply on Launchpad, but it goes through a verification process as well. Typically local shops is something which we can focus on right now, considering that your products would have much more of a local appeal. National demand, I'm not so sure if you will be able to cater to it right away, but we can start off with the local shops model.
All right, Anirudh. Thank you so much.
I have hello, can I speak?
Hello, good evening.
Hello, Sandhya, can I speak?
Hello, can I speak?
Anirudh?
Yeah, please go ahead.
Anirudh, I'm a woman entrepreneur dealing with organic groceries.
Correct.
So I had a question, but as I was going through your presentation, I want to ask you one thing. One is, you said for women entrepreneurs we have the Amazon Saheli thing, right, as a special
Correct.
thing.
Yes.
And suppose I'm selling organic groceries. Now you said about honey, okay?
Correct.
Honey, types of honey people have. Now if I'm a seller on Amazon, and you said there are some sponsorships and all too, but look, with the SEOs you will be like in the higher category, you said. It depends like how you get sponsorship, what we pay, the kind of scheme we take from you, right? How is Amazon helping the product to go up is it only with the money, with the kind of scheme of money we pay, or is it because there are so many people selling the same product?
Correct.
How far will your product get an importance on your website? I just wanted to know that. Is it only because you have to, you'll be having so many kinds of people selling honey, right?
Correct.
So how would I get?
Okay. Okay. Fair enough. Thank you for the question. So, like I mentioned, for any sponsored products, any new seller who comes and registers, there is a 2000 rupee free credit that is given to the seller. So as to kickstart the sponsored products campaign. Amazon per se does not, so we, like I mentioned, we operate through a marketplace model wherein we allow sellers to come and sell their products compared to, and they can compete with their respective sellers in their particular category. We essentially do not particularly promote any product per se, but yes, once you do reach certain thresholds, in fact, you can qualify even for deals as well, wherein, like for example, a lightning deal or a deal of the day, something which you must have seen on the Amazon deals page. You can qualify for those as and when, again, all this is very, very algorithmic and very, very, I mean, there is hardly any manual intervention in this. For a seller who gets good number of reviews, good number of ratings, those kind of SKUs then typically, what should I say, typically become much more eligible for deals and other promotions when it comes to Amazon. Apart from that, more than brand level promotions, it is more related to category level promotions. So for example, in the first 5 days, we will have something like a value day wherein Grocery Gourmet will typically be promoted across across brands and across selection on Amazon. We might have, in fact, if you might be aware, there was an Amazon Sambhav event which happened in January in Delhi, wherein Jeff Bezos had also come to come down to India, which, and the focus was again heavily towards the small and medium business enterprises as well. So yeah, there is definitely, there was a small and medium business day, a full 1 day promotion across Amazon India merchandising properties for small and medium businesses somewhere in November of last year as well. So yeah, there are promotions. There will not be any, I mean, it's very difficult to say whether we can provide individual level promotions, but it will be more related to, so that is why when we say the Amazon Saheli program, right? So we will not pick and choose any particular brands or products, but it will be ki Amazon Saheli ka promotion ho raha hai, ya fir Amazon Carrier ka promotion ho raha hai, or it could be something like Amazon SMBs ka promotion ho raha hai.
Okay. So that's what I was asking, because I am dealing with organic groceries, and I do also have a website. So if it is a great opportunity what the CIMSM is giving us for women entrepreneurs to sell our products through your website, and I'm sure that would really help us. And thank you for answering my question. Thank you, Anirudh. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Anirudh, from Chennai, I have a question. Am I entitled to ask you the question? Hello. I'm requesting to speak.
Hello.
Hello.
Can I speak, sir? Can I speak?
Hello. I'm requesting to speak.
Ask him something, please.
I guess you can control the participants by unmuting them. This is
This is Srivatsa Rajgopal from Chennai. I'm requesting to speak. Am I permitted to speak?
Please, sir.
Can I go ahead?
Yes, please.
Yeah, please.
Yeah, thank you. My question has two parts. Let me be short. First is, Are only traders eligible to get enlisted? We are manufacturer, okay? We manufacture health supplements, health the counter healthcare supplements like cordyceps, you know, cordyceps militaris, and all this. Okay, and we also do neutral labeling for others who actually buy from us and sell it as brands. Okay, now is a manufacturer like us eligible to get enlisted in Amazon? That's the first question. The second question is, can you throw further light on how the fulfillment center works? And because I'm looking at it more from the point of, you know, managing my inventory, will I get will I get a trigger on a replenishment, or, you know, what kind of visibility I will have over the stock which is kept? Thank you.
I think two great questions. I'll definitely answer both. Like I said, and I'm sorry if I didn't mention that earlier. In fact, manufacturers are more than welcome to sell. There are two things. One thing, you will definitely be manufacturing at scale. You will essentially know what is the product that the customer might need. And you would essentially be able to provide it at a much cost-effective price compared to a retailer which you are essentially selling it out to. Just one concern that we see with
just a second, can you just repeat after the disturbance goes off? I hear a lot of noise around.
Yeah,
please.
May I request the other participants to put their phone in a mute mode so that others can speak and listen and maybe share the valuable insights? It'll be great actually.
Okay.
Yes, please.
Vikas, can you just help me if you are able to answer a few of the questions within the chat box itself? That will be helpful. Rest of the questions, we can take it over the call.
Yeah, sure, Anirudh.
The second part of it regarding the inventory and the fulfillment center, please.
Yeah, sure. So manufacturers, like I mentioned, are more than welcome to come and sell online. Again, you would definitely have the most cost-effective price. You would essentially know what is the product. Just one concern, blocker which essentially comes with manufacturers is that, so this is like, it's a B2C model predominantly, right? So you also do have to get into that branding aspect and that merchandising and promotion aspect of your products as well. This is not wherein you can just do manufacturing in bulk and just sell it online. So if you take care of that part, I think, so we have got like I mentioned, so one of the key sellers with whom I have worked extensively over the last couple of years is a coir manufacturer. Again, a 100-year-old company, a coir mat manufacturer based out of Alleppey in Kerala. They've done like really, really good business over the last couple of years. But again, they have a very, very specific idea in terms of how do they want to market their products, how do they want to promote their products, what are the designs that they want to sell online. So yeah, if you can fix that part, then manufacturers is, and the products which you mentioned, right? Health supplements and orthopedics, I guess also you mentioned. Again, these are extremely in-demand products right now because of the situation that is out there. With respect to your second question in terms of fulfillment, when we say, so about, you know, you passing your goods in our fulfillment center, the onus will be on the seller to, so we do do the pickups from your particular warehouse basis the PIN code eligibility to our fulfillment centers as well. And the storage is taken care of by Amazon. The ownership of the inventory continues to be that of the seller, whereas the storage is something which Amazon takes care of, as well as the last mile delivery. So for example, if any order is coming into your seller portal, Amazon will package the products and dispatch it to the customer. And yes, you will definitely, once you do build some kind of a sales history on the portal through the fulfillment center, you will definitely start getting trigger and recommendations in terms of when do you replenish your inventory. So that product has kind of been built into our seller central systems.
Thank you. Thank you.
Hello.
Yes.
How the Amazon is hiding the payments of your sellers?
Sorry, I didn't get you.
How the Amazon is working on the payment? I want to know your payment structure.
The payment structure?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, so the last slide which I mentioned, right? So you can go on services.amazon.in for a much more detailed explanation in terms of how the payment structure works. But I'll just touch base on it slightly over here. What essentially happens, it's a pay-as-you-sell model. There is no cost for listing on Amazon. there's no cost for registering on Amazon. Now, what will typically happen is that once you receive a product, so there are three types of costs which would essentially be involved. One would be the referral fee, which is dependent on the category. One would be a fixed closing charge, which would be dependent on, the cost of the product as well as the fulfillment channel. And the third would be the fulfillment charge. In case if you are opting for an Amazon fulfillment, or say an easy kind of a model, wherein we pick up the product from, wherein Amazon picks up the product from your particular warehouse, then there will be a logistics cost involved as well. Apart from that, if you are opting for self-delivery of the product, then there will be no logistics cost, but there will be cost associated with that. So these are the three main costs which are associated with selling on Amazon. Apart from this, whatever is the operations cost or whatever is the cost that you incur for promoting your products, or any other maybe a return to reimbursement, whatever, etc., that is something which is over and above this. And yes, there was one question, that is GST mandatory for selling on Amazon? Yes, I think Vikas, can you answer that question?
Yes, thank you.
Hello.
Can I ask a question, Ajit?
Hello, can I ask a question, please?
Please go ahead. Hello. Please ask, sir.
Anurugji, may I know if you have any special schemes for women entrepreneurs? Because when we are talking about women empowerment and all the things, do you have anything which takes them over, show them over on top or something like that? Or special schemes for them? Hello?
Yes, sir. Hello, so what I'm doing is... Yeah. So for, I think I answered that question before as well. So what I'm doing is, in the chat, I'm just pasting a message, pasting a link on Amazon. Just one second. This is the Amazon Saheli program that we have. You can go through the link and that should answer most of the questions.
Hi, this is Banu. I want to ask a question regarding that.
Sir, I also have a question to ask.
Hello, sir. Can I proceed? Hello. Like you're mediator between buyers and sellers, right? Are you encouraging any new entrepreneurs, like between manufacturers and...
Yeah, sorry, I didn't get your question. Sir.
Okay. I'm repeating it again. I mean, Amazon is nothing but its mediator between buyers and sellers, right? You are right. In the online portal, you are posting your products, and I mean, if from online anybody is booking the products, you are just delivering them, right? For a correct. New entrepreneurs who want to become a new entrepreneurs, I mean, who don't have any tie, any I mean, networking things, will you provide any of the Amazon Launchpad programs? I mean, if I want to become a new entrepreneur, presently I'm not entrepreneur, but if I want to become a new entrepreneur, will you launch any programs? That's me I want to ask.
Yeah, so like I mentioned, we do have 3-4 programs which we did cover during the presentation. There is an Amazon Saheli program for women entrepreneurs. There is an Amazon Launchpad program for new entrepreneurs and startups. And also there is an Amazon Karigar program, which is there for handlooms and handicraft sellers. So what we'll do is I've posted the Amazon Saheli link. I'll also post the Amazon Karigar link and the Amazon Launchpad link as well. Again, you can go through. So these are typically the outreach programs that we have for startups. With a B2C product range for women entrepreneurs and for handicraft and handloom sellers. You can go through this and then send out a mail to Mr. Santosh with your interest, and then we can pick it up from there.
Okay, like in the sense, if I want to start a new business, from other side you are providing the opportunity, right? That's what you are saying, like these are the programs.
Yes.
Okay, can you paste it in the chat? I'll go through it. Okay.
Yeah, sure.
Hi, Anil. Hello, hello. Hi, Nader. Can I ask a question?
Yes, please, Sandeep. You can ask the question.
Yeah. Anirudh, basically, we are into community farming in Himalayan region of Uttarakhand. Hello.
Anirudh.
Hello. Sorry. Yeah. Sorry.
Anirudh, basically, we are into community farming in Himalayan region of Uttarakhand, and simultaneously, we are also promoting the handicrafts product from the Himalayan region of Uttarakhand. Right?
Okay.
So, what we are facing a challenge, there is basically fulfillment center challenges we are facing. So, just wanted to know, are you in process or do you have any future plan to open fulfillment center in a kind bit of remote areas? You know, presently what we have to do, we need to just like bring our product to main cities like Dehradun, Rudrapur, and you know, the plains area of the Uttarakhand. So, we are facing challenges to fulfillment, demand is there, but we are facing challenge to fulfill our product to the customer. Hello.
Yes, sir. Tell me.
Yeah, you got the question, Anirudh, or shall I?
So Mr. Sandeep, as of now, I'm not aware about any plans to set up any fulfillment center at Uttarakhand. But yeah, we can definitely check and get back to you if we have any plans of setting up a third party provider, something similar to what we even have in states like Kerala and Chhattisgarh. Wherein these third party warehouse, what they do is that they provide warehousing services, and you can park your inventory over there, and they will take care of the demand to the customer. So Amazon will pick up the products from these particular warehousing services.
Anirudh, I would like to add one thing. The third party model is not working because government is ready to collaborate. But now players are going to the uphills. They are only limited to set up their centers in the towns of Uttarakhand. That is the major problem we are facing.
Okay.
And due to that, you know, we are getting lag behind. The demand is good, but due to the lack of fulfillment, we are not able to procure our products.
Okay. Mr. Sandeep, I have noted down your question. Come back to Mr. Santosh and regarding this question, specific question regarding additional fulfillment capabilities for Uttarakhand, and I will pass on the details to him next
week. I'm mentioning my mobile number in the chat window. Please note it down and me know. Thank you very much.
Yeah, sure.
Thank you.
Hello, Anirudh. I have a question.
Yes, Abdul, you can ask your question.
Hi, we are a manufacturing company for Soba product, and my trademark is in process, and I want to place my product in Amazon. So, how can I place it?
What kind of products do you manufacture, sir?
Solar street light.
Solar street light. Puttu, do you want to take this question?
May I repeat?
Please repeat your question, sir.
So we are a manufacturing company and we have a product, solar street light, and I want to add this product in Amazon seller account, but I don't have any UPN number, so I want GTIN extension and I want to add this product. How can I do it?
Definitely, if you want to list without the top, also we can list your products. What you need to do is you need to take a GTIN exemption on your brand name, whatever the brand name you want to list it on. So once the GTIN exemption is approved, based on that, we can list your products on the Amazon sell portal. If you find any difficulty getting all these things done, I'm just dropping an email ID. you can contact me.
One specific question, can I ask?
Yes, Mr.
Is there any future plan for Amazon to enter the B2B segment? Right now it's purely B2C. I mean, is Amazon planning on in something like entering the business to business segment like an IndiaMart or an Alibaba?
So we do have a B2B section as well, but again it's again a little bit in the nascent stage. We do have a B2B site as well. We will post the link in the chat window for everyone to just browse through that. Yeah, we do have a Amazon B2B section as well, but again the B2C business for Amazon in India is considerably greater than the B2B section, but yeah, that is definitely one of the key growth areas for Amazon in India. In fact, few of the top categories in the B2B marketplace for Amazon India are your laptops and wireless devices, but a few upcoming categories are also hardlines categories as well. So exactly, sir, what's your profile? What exactly do you manufacture?
See, I manufacture healthcare supplements like cordyceps. You know about cordyceps, right? Cordyceps mushrooms. I mean, there's a medicine, okay, medicine which is extracted from that, and we do something called as the RYR, or the red yeast rice. Okay, and okay. We also extract pigments from spirulina called phycocyanin. So these are all, okay, our products. They have different uses. They have, I mean, use in medicines. They have use in cosmetics. They have use in many other food processing technologies and many other fields. But right now our channel has been only industrial sales, because we don't see our end customer. You know, we only get to see our channels, the companies that do, I mean, place order with us. They are the one who are in touch with the end customer. So I'm just trying to find out ways and means of trying to understand my final end customer through Amazon.
Yeah, we can definitely work something out through our B2B portal.
Thank you.
Okay, can I ask a question?
Vikrant, can I just take a couple of questions in the chat window first, please? Yeah. So is Amazon hiring third party godowns or warehouses? So there is a separate team for this. Right now, I'm not so sure in terms of are we going to hire any more third party godown or warehouses. But in case if there is any requirement, then I can definitely let Mr. Santosh know about it, and for which particular state will we require that kind of an assistance.
Okay.
Yeah, hi, Mr.
Actually, after this lockdown, many people are hope to lose their jobs, and they are planning to start their own something to like selling an online product or something like that. As you mentioned earlier, the target is to have a GST to get registered on the Amazon. So in this lockdown period and after the lockdown period, I don't think so that everyone could get the GST as immediately. It will take time for at least 15 or 20 days to get the things all clear and get the everything on track. So we think that now that without GST, we can register as a seller and get ahead with the selling all the things.
Sorry, Vikrant, actually GST is something which is required as per Government of India regulations. So without GST, I'm afraid to say this is something which we will not be able to proceed with further. But what we can do is that we have certain service providers, and where exactly are you based out of?
We're based out of Pune.
Pune, right? So we do have certain service providers who can expedite this process, but again, without GST, that's a Government of India regulations which Amazon has to comply with it 100%. So I'm sorry. I mean, we can get you contact details of certain service providers who can help in expediting the GST details.
Okay, that would be great if you can do that. Thank you.
Yeah,
Nirud.
Yeah.
I just want to ask you one question. Is this only to India, or is it to the abroad also? You are extending these programs.
So the programs which we have spoken about are Amazon India programs, and we are from the marketplace business development team, which takes which is under the vertical of Amazon India. But yeah, we do have a certain global sales team as well, who takes care of the question that you are kind of asking, wherein what are the services which Amazon provides for selling and predominantly for exporters who want to sell their products in other marketplaces like EU or US or UAE. So we do have a global sales channel as well.
Could you provide the details of this? Could you provide the link or at least?
Yeah, I can, I don't have it right now with me, but I can share it with Mr. Santosh.
Thank you.
Hello. I have a question. Can I ask?
Yes, please.
Hello. Okay. I am from Lucknow and I'm manufacturer of a health multigrain health mix. I have got myself listed on Amazon just a week before, but through a company I got it registered, and I now they are asking that if you want the management of your product on Amazon, then you have to pay something every month. So I want to ask that if, can that work be done by Amazon? We can do it by ourselves and not dependent on any other company to do that.
So there are different types of sales teams which operate, right? So typically that's a separate sales channel. So account management, the account management is a service that they are kind of providing to you. So for that kind of service, they are essentially asking for a remuneration. So that is between the third party service provider and the seller. So we don't have any say in that.
No, I want to ask that can we do that kind of account management by ourselves? Is it necessary to have somebody hired to do that?
No. So they see, like it's like any other service, ma'am. It's not something which is necessary. But yeah, if you are accustomed to the ways of selling online, I'm sure that you might not require it. But if you are extremely new, then I would recommend that you at least try it out for a few days, understand how the business works and how the operations work. And once you get used to it, once you understand the nitty-gritties of business, then maybe you can choose not to continue with it. But if you are an entry-level seller, then I would suggest that you continue with it for some amount of time, at least a month or two.
Okay, then how we can learn that? Is there any tutorial available that how to do all these things on Amazon?
Yes. There are tutorials. So when you have registered in your Seller Central account, there is a Seller University link which you can go and you can learn about selling on Amazon and the other nitty-gritties, the ones which I touched upon during today's presentation.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Hello.
Yes.
Hello. This is Madhu. I am into homemade products like chutney powder, something like that. Do I require GST for even those products initially?
Yes.
Okay.
GST is compulsory.
Okay. Thank you.
Any other questions?
Participants, if you have any questions, you can ask them.
Hello,
Anil.
Hi. Yes, hello. Sujata ma'am. Yes, Sujata ma'am, uh-huh. You can ask your question, please.
Hello. Hi, Anirudh. Hello, ma'am. Hello.
Please ask your question, ma'am.
Yeah. Is this platform is for export also? We can use it for export.
Omkar, do you want to take this question?
Yeah,
sure. Yeah. Can you, ma'am, can you just repeat the question, please?
This platform is used for export also. Like we can sell the product in Amazon.com.
Yes. So we have a team called as Global Sales. Okay. So you mean to say sitting in India, you want to sell your products on the other Amazon subsidiaries, right?
In Amazon Saheli or something like, after that we can sell the products, we can export the products also. That is my question.
Yes, yeah, definitely. So the point is that, see, Amazon Saheli or Amazon Karigar, these are all program enrollment programs, whereas Global Sales, Fulfillment by Amazon, Seller Flex, these are modes of fulfillment. Okay, So Saheli is something which is more a holistic development of your business on the platform. Okay, whereas global sales is what will enable you to sell your products on Amazon.com, Amazon.eu, Amazon Australia, or Amazon, or any other Amazon subsidiary which is available. Currently, Emirates, EM, which is the souk website which Amazon has taken over. Okay, so Saheli is basically a guidance for women entrepreneurs to increase their business. Now, how they choose to increase their business is totally upon you. Like, for example, global sales will also, meaning invite some investment into all your export licenses and stuff like that. You can definitely, under the umbrella of Amazon Saheli, you will get guidance for various programs to sell in India, to sell in abroad, sell on Seller Flex, sell in Fulfillment by Amazon. Multiple guidances you will get in that. But basically, Amazon Saheli will help you to list you as a woman entrepreneur in the special Amazon Saheli section, which is dedicated to women entrepreneurs on the Amazon website. My colleague must have shared the Saheli link over here.
Yeah, he shared that.
Yeah, you can go and visit that. All this exporting then or the mode of selling is, comes at a later stage.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I have one more question.
Hello. We are already listed on Amazon. Then can we still apply on the Amazon Saheli portal?
Sorry?
If we are already listed on Amazon, then can we still apply on the Amazon Saheli and all that portals also?
Yeah, so you will. So there are certain benefits. If you go through the link, it mentions that there are certain programs if you directly enrolled via the Saheli program. In case if you are already listed on Amazon and you want to take part in the Saheli program, then a few, you might not be able to avail a few of those benefits. But yeah, you will definitely be part of any future merchandising which happens with respect to the Amazon Saheli store.
Okay, so that involves also if we are bringing new products for ourselves which are not listed on Amazon yet. And so can we apply to that Amazon Saheli, those products and some products through already listed things?
That is something which you will have to. So Amazon Saheli is not essentially product specific, it is seller specific.
This is a more holistic program you said. No? It is more of development of women entrepreneurs, I suppose.
So that is what he's saying. It is not product specific, ma'am. It is, sorry, Omkar here, it is seller specific. So you as a seller, whatever, once you are MC, the thing is that the program is there to promote women entrepreneurs, right? So if you,
yes,
if,
okay.
when someone enrolls through Saheli directly, that time there are some added benefits. Okay, even though we are not the directly concerned team for Saheli, but the basic understanding of it for launching through Saheli, there are some basic benefits, extra benefits. But having said that, if you are already a woman entrepreneur who is selling on Amazon, you can still enroll in Saheli program. Of course, the benefits which you are given at launch will not be applicable, but that is not all about it. There are some common benefits.
That's what I wanted to ask because we didn't know about this Amazon Saheli. So we got listed ourselves.
Yeah.
So I wanted to ask that are we missing on those then? That's what I wanted to ask.
There must be some basic benefits, ma'am. Finally, the larger interest is to empower a woman entrepreneur. That's it. So you might not be losing on major part of it.
Okay, so we have to just go and see then what it is exactly, how it is.
Yeah,
offered.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. There is one. If you check the link, there is one form which you have to fill, application form. Okay, once you fill the form, they will reach back to you.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Okay, yes.
Okay. Hi.
This
can
is
I
ask
the link, sir?
Nikita?
Hello.
Can you share the link, sir? For the Saheli?
Hello.
Link is already has been shared multiple
Nikita
times.
Goes?
It is also there.
Yes, Nikita, this side. Can I speak?
Yes, please.
Hi, I am Nikita. I'm from Lucknow. And this program seemed very interesting. If I wanted to register with Amazon for products And there was a question that for selling it abroad. So apart from the GST and the export import license, is there any other document or a license that is required from the seller then?
Meaning this, we call it, like I told you, it is called global sales. Okay. So every country has its different demands for export needs. Okay. So it starts on which country you want to start first. Okay. Or if you want to go for whether you want to go for multiple countries. So there is one common set of documents, and there are some country specific documents. Okay. Just to explain to you, so the four of us who are from Amazon who are currently connected here are a part of a team called as direct sales. Okay. So we are more responsible for getting a seller on board and growing them in for India marketplace. Okay. Saheli, Karigar, Global Sales, these are all additional B2B, these are all additional teams which are available on Amazon. So here we are. So all the specific detailed questions, you can reach out through us through Mr. Santosh, and we can take it from there. Or we have shared all our email IDs. Just reach out to us. We will redirect you to the correct teammates. Our team is from those particular teams.
Right. Thank you so much. Thanks.
Pleasure.
Hello. Hello. Yeah, can I ask you a question, sir?
Yes,
Mandy. Yeah, please go ahead.
Sir, actually, I wanted to know, we are manufacturers of GCP, guaiac calcium phosphate. It's actually nil rate of nil rate of GST. Actually, it's not taxable product.
Okay.
Still, do we require GST for non taxable products?
First and foremost, it's a pharmaceutical product. So, is it over the counter or it is prescription related?
No, it's not prescription related. It's actually for cattle feed. It's actually a cattle feed.
Cattle field. Yes, sir. Yeah. GST is required. Even though it is nil GST, that is but for selling it, you still require registering yourself on Amazon. You still require a GST. GST, like Anirudh said, is absolutely compulsory. There is no leeway to that. But just out of curiosity, is that DCP the only product you are sharing that you are not having a GST at all?
No, I am having a GST. I am not talking about me. I have given you an example. But we are the manufacturer of GCP and other products also. So we are having a GST. I am talking about general thing so that everyone can benefit.
Then we are talking at a different level. The point is that if you are having other products which attract GST, so for selling on Amazon, you will require GST. Now, when you are listing DCP as a product to be sold, you can choose for the customer to be not incurring any GST. But that also is an exception. Currently, there is no arrangement to it. But this is an exceptional case. The system is never made for exceptions. Okay, it is made for the interest of the larger good. Whenever a seller comes with some exception, we then talk to our finance teams or other teams. That here is an exception which has come up. Please help us.
Okay. Yeah. So again, you go in for your legal teams and then do whatever is required.
Exactly.
Okay. And another thing, sir, in order to as I told you, my product is GCP, that's animal cattle field. Okay.
Correct.
If I want to list here, the quantum will be very less. Quantum will be very less. The number of clicks we receive will be less.
Right.
For our product.
Okay.
Is it advisable for us also to come up with our product to you on your platform?
Definitely. So meaning if you have seen the presentation, there are initiatives like sponsored products, sponsored brands, where you can give visibility to your product. Okay. But having said that, this becomes a very specific purpose product, right? Even though you are a private label, cattle feed.
Animal
cattle feed. So cattle feed is a very, very specific purpose product. Okay. So there will be a different strategy which we will have to work around. But having said that, for listing, you are not, no one is charging you anything, right? Only once it gets sold, you will have to pay the commission. So there is no worry in listing it. Listing is, it is not going to harm you anyway.
Because see, Agar Kings also has to go up. Like we are only right now, we are making bulk packing. Again, we have to go in for smaller packs, and all those kings are comes into picture. That's the reason why I'm asking you.
You are right. You'll have to customize this for retail. Yeah. I'm sure you must be currently. Yeah. You must be currently selling it in distribution or wholesale. You'll have to definitely customize it for retail. There is no doubt in that. Absolutely. But the point is
reason why. Now, can you please help me? How many people say I'm not talking about the main line like groceries or the clock or mobiles and all those things are the mainstream. I'm talking about the off screen. How many products are there in the off screen? Or how many categories are there?
Yours is a very little bit more, what you call it, pointed query. Okay. What we will do is we will discuss in detail offline. Okay, we have shared our number and email ID. Can you reach out directly? Because it's a very specific product. So we will also have to do some background study from our side. But definitely, it's very interesting. We'll take it up.
Okay.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Mangit Maheshwari.
Okay, definitely. We'll be looking forward to your...
Maheshwari from Rajahmundry, Andhra Pradesh.
Sure, sir.
I'm Mangit Maheshwari from Rajahmundry. Yeah, please.
Okay, sir.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Hello, can I speak?
Yes, please.
Actually, I am already a seller on Amazon, and I want to know if I want to connect with the local shops, and so how can I start selling with the local shop on Amazon?
Sorry, I didn't catch your name.
My name is Shruti.
Yeah, hi Shruti. So you are basically based out of which locality?
Kolkata.
Okay, and what are the products that you are dealing in currently?
Currently, I'm dealing in women apparels.
Okay, so you want to do local shops for apparel?
No, not local. Even local would do. In terms of the essentials that I want to sell. Like I'm dealing in only women apparel, but I want to expand to other branches. So that is what am I asking.
Calcutta, right? Okay, you just do one thing. You drop your details over here. My team will pick it up. Okay, and we will reach out to our team in Calcutta to get in touch.
Hello.
Okay, sure. Okay, then I'll share my details.
Shopkeeper, sir. Thanks, sir. Actually, address Shalimar Bagh.
Next question, please.
Any more questions, please?
Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
No, I think we can, by taking another 2-3 questions, we can wind up.
Hello, this is Shrikant from Andhra Pradesh. Is it audible?
Yes.
Yeah, I have one question. Just like we have a CFS. Like Amazon have a own CFS, or it is only utilizing of like it is a B2 customer selling, so it is only from collection from the product from the seller and giving to next end user. So this is only the process Amazon doesn't have, or it is have a own CFS also?
It is not clear, sir. I meaning that I am not understanding. Aniru, do you take this?
CFA means warehouses.
Acha, clearing forwarding Amazon, agents.
Yes, Amazon have itself have own warehouses, or it is only deal directly with the sellers and customers only.
No, that is what the FBA process is about, right? So you make an account, you can place your products, or that means you can park or store your products in Amazon fulfillment centers. That is what is called FBA, fulfillment by Amazon. This is nothing got to do with CFA.
Okay.
Yeah. So you have to yourself deliver your products to the or get your products delivered to Amazon warehouses.
Okay.
Yeah.
From Amazon warehouses, you will take care of the delivery to the customer.
Yeah. We will take care of the delivery to the customer. Yeah, correct.
Yeah, Mr. So Srikant, what exactly do you sell? What exactly do you manufacture?
I have actually, like, I'm in a service industry, but I have a doubt. Like, I am dealing with the unisex salons here.
Okay.
So just I want to ask you about that process only, that's why. And one more thing, like, we have a online service providers websites also. So like that, now as of now, Amazon is dealing with only goods. Is it any in future, is it comes to any service also?
Maybe. I mean, we are not really aware of any future plans right now, so we can't comment. But yeah, I'm sure there must be something in the road. Okay. So there is something called as Amazon Home Services, but again, that is very much related to after sales service of, for example, television delivery.
No. I'm speaking clear. I'm asking only for a selling of service. Nothing but I am dealing with a unisex salons.
Srikant, nothing of that as of now. We may or may not have something in the future. I mean, we are not, our team is not aware of that right now.
Okay. Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Anirudh, I have a question. Anirudh, I have a question. Can I ask?
Yes, sure.
Okay, so I would like to sell food products made at homemade food products. So what are the kind of certifications that I will need before I can start listing it over there?
Sure. Puturaj, do you want to take up this question?
Yes, Anirudh. Hi, Santosh. So what you need to do is, minimum requirement for the products to be listed in the grocery category is the FSSAI certificate, and plus the shelf life of the product should be minimum 3 months. If these two conditions are okay, then we can list your products on Amazon.in.
You are saying listing only on Amazon?
Listing of the products on Amazon.in, the basic requirements are the FSSAI certificate, GST document, plus the shelf life should be more than 3 months.
Okay. The FSSAI certificate, the GST, and shelf life should be 3 months.
Yes, more than 3 months.
All right.
Okay. Yeah, hello.
And it is for Amazon groceries or anything like that, then Amazon Fresh or Amazon groceries?
Those two are different vertical. As of now, I'm talking about marketplace, that is dot in.
Okay, noted. Thank you.
Yeah. Hello.
Hello.
Yes, madam.
Hello, may I ask it? Question?
Yeah, sure. Please.
Sir. So, I'm a woman entrepreneur, but my company also have males. Like, it is not 50-50%. So, is there for Saheli program, is there any requirement, right, that it should be more than 50% of women in the startup?
Ma'am, this is actually a bit technical, but hello, Omkar here. This is a bit technical, but the point being, in the part, in the owners of the company, right? What is the what is the partnership like?
Okay.
I'm asking you, what is the in the owner ownership of the company?
Fine, fine. Okay, thank you. Okay. Okay.
Hello.
In the ownership, that's what I'm saying. It is for 47% is women. Yeah. In the ownership, we are so it is like 47% is women and.
30% is check that one in the Amazon Sahili team, and ma'am, we can get back to you on that. Can you please drop a message on the chat window so that we can just let you know the details? Yeah.
Hello.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
Hello. Actually, I am a new user on seller on Amazon. So I have a problem when I am listing the product on over there. They are asking for product ID, but I don't even know what I add there. So I face so many difficulties. Can you help me? Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Can you hear me? Hello.
Yeah. Can you please repeat? Can you please repeat your question?
Yeah. Sure. मैं जब Amazon पे product listing करने जाती हूँ ना तो वहाँ पे क्या issue आता है मेरे को? They were asking me for product ID, like UPI and GST and whatever. But जब मैं GST या कुछ डालती हूँ वो pick नहीं करता है, उसको wrong show करता है और वो update नहीं हो पाता है. तो आप मुझे बताएंगे इसका solution क्या और कैसे होगा?
Okay. आप एक काम कर सकते हैं मैम. या विकास प्लीज कंटिन्यू.
या पूजा विकास दिस साइड. ये जो आपको प्रोडक्ट आईडी का इशू आ रहा है इसमें हम लोग यूपीसी एग्जम्पशन ले सकते हैं प्रोडक्ट पे. सेलर सेंट्रल पे आप जब जाते हो तो वहाँ पर राइट साइड में एक सर्च बॉक्स रहता है, वहाँ पर यूपीसी एग्जम्पशन आप टाइप करोगे, एक लिंक आएगा, उसमें आपको अपने प्रोडक्ट का टाइटल, प्रोडक्ट का जो टाइटल होता है और तीन फोटो डालना होता है. विद इन टू आवर्स में आपको अप्रूवल मिल जाएगा.
ओके, सिंगल प्रोडक्ट का मुझे तीन फोटोज डालना है, यू मीन टू से?
हाँ, जैसे आपको किसी ब्रांड का अप्रूवल चाहिए तो वो ब्रांड का अप्रूवल आप यूपीसी एग्जम्पशन से ले सकते हैं. फिर उसी ब्रांड के अंदर अगर आप लिस्ट करोगे तो फिर आपका हो जाएगा.
ओके, मतलब बेसिकली मुझे अपना ब्रांड रजिस्टर करवाना पड़ेगा पहले?
नहीं 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 नहीं, इसी को मैं बोल रहा हूँ यूपीसी एग्जम्पशन. इसमें आपको एक्चुअली
मैंने यूपीसी एग्जम्पशन ट्राई किया था बट इट डजंट वर्क. सो वही मैं चीज बोल रही हूँ, शायद मैंने या फिर इंफॉर्मेशन करेक्ट नहीं भरा होगा या आई डोंट नो व्हाट
हैपेंड. ओके, नो प्रॉब्लम पूजा, हमने मेल आईडी दिया हुआ है, आप अपना इशू एक मेल ड्रॉप कर दो उस पे, हम लोग आपके साथ कनेक्ट हो जाएंगे फिर.
ओके, थैंक यू सर.
लास्ट कपल ऑफ क्वेश्चंस एंड आई गेस वी आर एनीवेज आउट ऑफ time, it's 5 o'clock. We'll take last couple of questions and all the other questions can be routed through to Mr. Santosh or Mr. Sandhya.
Hi, yeah, it's Sapna Bajaj here. Hello. Hello.
No, ma'am, ma'am, I'm calling in Chennai. Hello.
Yes, Sapna.
Yeah, I just wanted to know, like.
Yes, Sapna, go ahead.
I found. Hello, I found the session today really very interesting, and I just wanted to know, like, what are the rules for registration as an Amazon seller? How much GST is to be paid and all?
Yeah, so for that, in the presentation, there was one last slide which spoke about commercials. You can note down this website, services.amazon.in.
Okay.
In that you can as per your category, you can understand how much is the commission that you'll be charged. Okay. Before that, where are you based, Sapna?
I'm from Hyderabad.
Okay. And what is the product that you are selling?
Sweet chili sauce.
Sorry?
Sweet chili sauce.
Okay. So Mr. Vikash Sahu has given his contact details. Okay. What you do is you also put down your contact details over here, your email ID and phone number. We will reach out to you as a part of our regular pitch process.
Sure. Thank you.
Thanks for the positive feedback. Yeah.
Thank you. Welcome. Thank you.
Hello.
Last question, last question, please.
Hello. I'm
Yeah,
Aryan
last
Aga.
question, please. Yeah, yes,
May
sir.
I please go on? Sir, why some people are suspended on Amazon sellers? Hello.
Okay, I think the last
Hello.
question was the most is the most difficult one to answer. Okay, thank you, sir, for asking that question. Again, so while I did mention that, I mean, the marketplace is definitely open for sellers to come register and start selling. There at time happens to be certain bad actors there. That is why, basis the policies of Amazon India Marketplace, there might be certain sellers who might be suspended. Also, there are instances wherein, if for example, you are not adhering to the performance metrics of Amazon fulfillment, for example, it could be EasyShip or it could be say FBA, or maybe if the customers are voicing the fact that a defective product is reaching to the customers, that is also when there might be a possibility that basis certain objective criteria within the framework of Amazon India rules and regulations, certain sellers might be suspended.
Okay, and then I need a packaging material.
Hello, Sandhya ma'am.
Yes, Anirudh.
Yeah, I think we are anyways past our time. If there are any other questions, can we route them through Mr. Santosh?
Yeah,
Or you, I mean,
sure,
yeah.
Anirudh, we can do it. So with this, we come to the end of the session. Thank you so much, Anirudh, and your colleagues also. It was an excellent session. I think by now all the participants, we have got good knowledge about the entire process, how Amazon is going to help all the business entrepreneurs. Thank you so much, and I would like to thank all the participants also. Thank you so much. Bye.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am. Thank you for
Last,
the
I would also like to
opportunity.
thank everyone. I would like to thank everyone.
You're welcome, sir. Thank you.